In this video, we will study the response curve of parallel LCR circuit. And here we will determine the anti-resonance frequency and quality factor. This is the circuit diagram for the parallel LCR circuit. This is the resistance and this is the capacitor and this is the inductor. And both capacitor, inductor and also the resistor, all are connected in parallel. This is one terminal connected to this side and another terminal connected to this side. So all are connected in parallel, and this potential is connected in parallel, or the voltmeter is connected in parallel, and ammeter or milliammeter, here we have taken milliammeter, which is connected in series, and input audio frequency AC signal is given here. What is anti-resonance in parallel LCR circuit? In parallel LCR circuit, if you use the vector diagram or analytical solution, then you will see the total current I square will be equal to IR square plus IL minus IC whole square. This is from the triangle of vector addition. You will get, applying Pythagoras theorem, you will get this equation. So I will be equal to IR square plus IL minus IC square root, and we know IR is equal to V divided by R, current passing through the resistor is equal to potential divided by R. Here potential remains same in all the three components because of it is parallel connection, so potential remains same. So IR will be equal to V by R in inductor, IL will be equal to V by XL, where XL is called the capacitor, inductor reactance. Similarly, IC is the V divided by XC, where XC is called the capacitor reactance, and that is equal to V divided by Z. Here Z is called the impedance. So if you compare these two equations, this equation and this one, here we have taken 1 by Z is equal to this factor, 1 by R square plus 1 by XL minus 1 by XC whole square. If you take V square common, then square root of V square, it will be V. So other factor will be equal to this one. And you can take this equal to 1 by Z. So here Z is the impedance of the parallel LCR circuit. And you see, if XC is equal to XL, then what will happen? Z will be equal to R. So in parallel LCR, the frequency at which the amplitude is minimum is called the anti-resonant frequency. You can calculate the anti-resonance frequency where the frequency is minimum. So let us see how you can find out the anti-resonant frequency. You can find out the anti-resonance frequency from the response curve of parallel LCR, or that is called the frequency response curve. You take frequency along x-axis and the current along y-axis, current in the circuit along y-axis. And in the experiment, we have frequency range from 100 Hz to 100 kilohertz, and the current range from 0 to 25 milliampere. And if you plot a graph taking frequency along x-axis and current along y-axis, then the nature of the graph will be like this. And this is the frequency at which Z equal to R, and this frequency is called anti-resonance frequency, at which the impedance of the circuit is minimum. Current is a minimum, means impedance is maximum. We have seen in series LCR circuit, impedance at resonance is minimum because current at resonance is maximum. And in case of parallel LCR circuit, impedance at resonance is maximum, so the current at resonance is minimum. Then how can calculate the quality factor in parallel LCR circuit? Quality factor is equal to, in terms of R and L, it is R divided by twice pi FR into L, and in terms of R and C, twice pi FR into RC, and in terms of C and L, LC and R, it is R square root of C divided by L. So from the known values or given values in the circuit you have known values of R, you have fixed value of L, and FR you calculate from the response curve of parallel LCR circuit, and putting all these values you can calculate the quality factor of the circuit. Then you draw a table taking number of observation and frequency in hertz and current in milliampere, and in the experiment you take different values of frequency and the corresponding value of the current, and you plot a graph, and the nature of the graph will be as we have discussed. So now let us see how we'll do the experiment. So this is the parallel LCR circuit. You see, this is the capacitor terminal, this is the inductor terminal. Here inductor is fixed value, you cannot change it, and this is the resistor terminal, socket for the resistor, and also you have voltmeter, socket for the voltmeter, and it is connected to the voltmeter here from 0 to 5 volt. The range is 0 to 5 volt, and you have terminal or the socket for the milliammeter. You connect the milliammeter, you see, from 0 to 25 milliampere milliammeter, you connect it, and this is the input signal. And you give sine wave to the in the input, and this is the audio frequency output. From this audio frequency output you connect the input signal. Okay, and you see this is the capacitor, output of the capacitor. You have three capacitors, 0.1, 0.22 and 0.33. You connect it to the capacitor terminal. This is different resistance, you connect it to the resistance terminals. You have no inductors, only one inductor, but different capacitors and different resistors. This is the set amplitude. You set the amplitude to basically 3 volt. This is the voltmeter, which ranges from 0 to 5 volt. You set the amplitude to 3 volt, and this is your frequency code, frequency for the 100 hertz to this is 100 hertz. Then you have 1k. Then you have switch for 10k. Okay, you have three adjustments, and this is the fine adjustment of frequency. One, if you place it at 1, then 100 into 1, it will be equal to 100 hertz. If you place it at 2, then it will be 100 into 2, 200 hertz, like this. Now I am connecting the circuit. I am connecting first the capacitor. You see, I am connecting the capacitor first, then I will connect the resistor. You see, I am connecting the resistor. I am connecting one terminal or one port of the resistor, then I am connecting the other terminal of the resistor in the board. Resistor, I have connected the resistor. Now I am connecting the milliammeter. You see, I am connecting the milliammeter, one terminal of the milliammeter I have connected,
then I will connect the second terminal, because the millimeter is in series, so you connect it, the millimeter is connected in series. I have connected the millimeter. Now I will connect the voltmeter. This is one terminal of the voltmeter which is in parallel, and you see this is the another terminal of the voltmeter. I am connecting it in parallel. Then I will connect the audio frequency oscillator, AF oscillator. This is the input of the signal to the circuit. This is another port for the signal oscillator. It is sine wave oscillator. Here we have taken sine wave oscillator. Now you switch the circuit. You switch on the circuit. First you set the amplitude. Set amplitude to 3 volt. If you you can see the voltage in the voltmeter for the set amplitude. You set it to nearly 3 volt. Okay. So it is 3 volt. Then you increase the frequency. Then you increase the frequency. As you have discussed, when you increase the frequency, the current will decrease. From the graph I have shown you, when you increase the frequency, you see the current will decrease. Because if it is at lower frequency, 100, multiplication of 100, the maximum you will get up to 1K here. So up to 1K you see there is no increase in the current. Now what you do? You increase the current range. I am increasing it to 1K switch. The core switch I have changed to 1K. Now I am increasing the fine frequency switch. You see, when you increase the frequency, the current will decrease. It is decreasing, you see. And you record the decrease. The amount of current you decrease it slowly, then the current, you see, it is increasing. As I have told you in the graph, first the current will decrease, then when you increase the frequency, the current will increase. Then you change the core switch to 10K. Now you take the fine switch to 0. Again you increase. You increase the fine switch. And you can see again there is a decrease, there should be increase of the current. And you see here in 10K there is no increase in the current. So you limit it at 1K. For the resistance I have taken 50 ohm. You can repeat this experiment with different resistances. You can use 75 ohm, 100 ohm, 125 ohm, like this. And you can also change the capacitor, value of the capacitor, and repeat the same experiment, and you will get different types of curve, frequency response curve for parallel LCR.